God bless you all. And this is Brother Stephen Chimbo, local pastor in Spoken Word Tabernacle of Gastonia here in North Carolina in the United States. This is an expo that we have done in about music. And music has been such a treacherous subject, very contradictory in the past, until that we noticed that the music that the message believers are listening to up to now got into the way that is swaying to the world. There is no gauge, there is no standard for it, and we felt impressed in our heart to be able to address this subject with all humility and according to the message of the hour. And we trust that this exposition of music will be a tremendous blessing to you. And for those who are local shepherd, that are shepherd many group all over the world, if you come across this tape or this video, you can use it as a baseline. And I know there are several quotes that Brother Branham mentioned about music, but I was not able to put it all there. But at least we have a core from where we can work together, and then you can add every single remaining quote into it for the betterment of your church. So enjoy music part one, and then don't stop at part one, because that's not all. You will continue with music part two all the way to part three. And I believe by the grace of God, the Holy Spirit will enlighten you and make sure that whatever predicament the devil tried to bring into this message will be stopped, and the children of God will be free to worship God in the spirit and in the truth with their clapping, with their dancing, with their music, and music that is acceptable and appropriate for the children of God. God richly bless you. We love you all, Bride of Jesus Christ. Brother Stephen Chimbo, thank you.
Thank you, thank you. Let's go straight to our scripture. Glory, glory, hallelujah. If I can put this in. 2 Timothy chapter 2. Praise God. Very familiar scripture if you've been in question and answer. Amen. Verse 23, but foolish and unlearned questions avoid, knowing that they do gender strife. And the servant of the Lord must not strive, but be gentle unto all men, apt to teach and patient. The end, I put it, not the scripture. I don't want to add anything. Comma, patience. Amen? Amen? Let's go to Titus chapter 3, verse 9. Amen. If you dare, you can say amen. Amen. Verse 9, but avoid foolish questions and genealogies and contentions and strivings about the law, for they are unprofitable and vain. So we don't want to answer those questions about genealogy, contention, or striving about the law. It's not, there's no purpose to spend time on it, because the scriptures say they're unprofitable and vain. In other words, it's not going to work. Amen? Amen? Glory to God. So let's go ahead and pray. Brother Kelly, go ahead and pray, please.
Hallelujah. Lord God, we thank you for your grace, your mercy, Lord God, for just giving us another opportunity, Lord Jesus, to come in thy presence once again. And Lord God, so we thank you for the precious sisters, Lord God, that prepare the natural food, Now, Lord Jesus, you know your servant, Lord God, the laboring in love you saw this day before the foundation of the world, Lord God. The enemy was fighting many of us this week, but you gave us strength to come in your presence once again. Now, Lord God, anoint your servant, Lord God. We remove every demon force that would try to trouble the hearts and the mind of your children this afternoon. Father, you said you raise up the standard when the enemy come in like a flood. So we need a word from you, Lord God. So anoint him, strengthen him, Lord God. We give you praise. We give you honor. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen.
Amen. You might be seated. Question number one. You ready?
Amen.
It's about music, okay? We had music session part two. We had part one, part two. There's a couple questions I felt about. Touch it, and then we can move on soar. Amen? So that's the reason why I want to record it. It's pretty much this one. And there is another thing that I want to record it in case one of these days the tape is released. So you have a baseline to go by it. Amen? The question, just, it's a question. So don't get upset. It's just a question. Amen?
Amen.
Music. Okay. I don't know whether the person was in part one or part two, or they were one of them, or they missed one of them, but the question came up. So if it came up, let's go ahead and handle it. If they were not in part one or part two, that's definite a reason why you missed it. But if you were there and maybe you missed something, let's go ahead and emphasize. What music, if any, can Christians listen to with their spouse? Speaking of romantic music, I told you it's a question. Amen.
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 Let me read it again. I just told you it was a question. Amen.
Amen.
Oh, glory to God. Okay, I'm glad you're getting in the mood, okay? So nobody sleep. Amen. You see that part one, knock this out. Part two, bury it. But let's go ahead again. Amen? What music, if any, can Christian listen to their spouse? Speaking of romantic music. Like Park Sad, Diana Ross. Hey. Love music. It's a question that came out. In other words, I'm going to rephrase that question. In other words, between you and your spouse, in the love relationship, can we listen to love songs? That's a question. So I don't know if the person was in part one or part two, but I'm not going to tell you the name. So you will never know that person. Amen? I keep it to myself. This one, I can keep it to myself. Not to you. I will not tell you the name. Amen? And I'll make sure when I take this, I destroy it completely so you will never know where it came from. Amen? So I keep it secret between me and the Lord, period. Amen? But there is nothing wrong. Probably the person was not in part one, or probably they missed part one and part two, or probably there is still something that they miss somewhere. So let's go ahead and help. Amen? Because some people might be further away and some are still dragging a little bit behind. But we want to make sure everybody is on the same page. Amen? So you got the question, right? Glory, glory, hallelujah. Amen. If you recall, music, when we start about music, I'm just going to be brief. We talk about the two powers. We talk about the two sources. We talked about the two kingdoms. In other words, there is not a neutral music. It's either Satan or it's either God. But Satan, you can blend him with God. He doesn't have any problem. But God is the only one that he have to be 100% God. Everybody okay? So if it's Christian music, he have to be 100% God. If even you put 1% of the devil, the Lord won't take it. Everybody okay? Even if you put 0.00009%, that little 0.0009% is enough to cause trouble. So either it's godly or it's not. That's godly. But the devil, you can be on his side or you can be on his side and blended with God. He's still okay with it. Amen? And if you recall the age, we're in the age of mixture. Amen? And with those two sources, the two powers, the two kingdoms, comes two music. Amen? Amen? It's either the music of God or it's the music of the devil. Period. Everybody okay? The middle ground is always the devil. Everybody okay? Let me put it this way so he stays with you. If this is God, and over here you got the devil. Amen? Everything that is here, on this side, right here, everything that is here is still God. Amen? What is in between here, it's not God. Amen? This one is Christian. Everybody okay? This one is also Christian. And this one is secular. Amen? But to God, everything that is starting from here, all the way there, all the way, whether it's this Christian and this secular, both of them to God are bad. Everybody okay now? So you keep this. So there is no in between right here. This in between, this is the age of Laodicea. Amen? Because you are neither hot nor cold, you are lukewarm. And when you lukewarm, this is exactly where you get the trouble, and that's where the devil gets you. Amen? So now, we talked about the theme of the music. If you remember, on part two, who are you singing the music to? Amen? Who are you directing the music to? Are you directing the music to God, to a personality, to the devil, or to who? It is very important when the music is sung, we want to know who are we singing the music? Who are we worshiping? Who are we praising? Who are we dancing for? Amen? Now, if we take romantic music, does romantic music have anything to do with God inside? Everybody okay? You have everything that is romantic have to be doing with love. But which love? Because there's two love. Everybody okay? Is it agape love or is it filial love? Romantic have completely, it's either filial love or it goes to lustful love. You remember? We went through the step of love all the way down. Now, this is the way I'm going to answer this question. We got two kingdoms. Amen? We call them two power. Amen? Today, I'm going to call them two wisdom. Everybody okay? Let's go to the book of James. If you're there, you can say amen. Those two sources are two kingdoms. Those two kingdoms got two music. They got two power. They also have two wisdoms. Amen? One wisdom is also called faith. That's why Brother Branham preached a message, wisdom versus faith. Amen? The other wisdom was the wisdom from the devil. The other one was from God. Amen? Amen? Amen. Let's go to the book of James chapter 3. If you're there, you can say amen. Matter of fact, before we go to James, if you don't mind, amen, let's go to 1 John chapter 2. So let me refresh this quick so we can get to James. 1 John chapter 2. Verse 16. Amen. All these things that are bad, they are bad for a reason. Amen. And they are bad because of three reasons. Let me put it this way. Amen. Okay. You ready? 1 John chapter 2, verse 16. For some things. For what? In other words, everything that is of this world, of this cosmos, this system. For all that is in the world. The what? Remember these things. We went through, but I'm going to go here. The lust of the flesh. This is where your romantic music is. Everybody okay? Kama. And the lust of the water. Your romantic music. Everybody okay? And the water. The pride of life. Amen? The lust of the flesh, the lust of the eyes, and the pride of life is not of the water, but it's of the water. So if something is coming in the music and it's promoting the lust of the flesh, is it godly?
No.
Because the lust of the flesh is not from the Father. Amen? The lust of the eyes is not from the Father. And the pride of life won't come from God. In other words, whatever you see on the TV or what you hear on the music, if he have these three attributes, or it's stressing, or it's underlining, or it's insisting, or it's promoting these three things, just completely know that the source is wrong. Because the Father will never produce the lust of the flesh. Everybody okay? The Father will never produce the lust of the eyes. And the Father will never produce the pride of life, because God is humble. Amen. Everybody okay? Amen. The Bible says in verse 17, and the world passeth away, and the lust thereof. But he that doeth the will of God abideth how? Amen. Let's go now to the book of James chapter 3. Romantic music. When you're listening to it, what is that music stressing? Amen? Is it stressing something godly? Is it stressing the passions, the lust of the flesh or the eyes? When you're listening to that slow music, what are you hearing? What is it bringing to your memory? What is it doing to your body? Is it bringing you holiness? Or it's actually accentuating lust. We okay? James chapter 3, verse 13. If you dare, you can say amen. What I say, there is two kingdom, two power. We call them two sources. And today I'm going to call them two wisdom, because we already talked about the wisdoms. Verse 13, who is a wise man and endue with knowledge among you? Let him show out of a good conversation his work with meekness and what? Of wisdom. But if ye have bitter envying and strife in your heart, glory not and lie not against the truth. This wisdom, watch carefully, descended not from above. So there is two wisdom. There is a wisdom that comes from above, and there is another wisdom that is coming from hell. Amen? This wisdom descended not from above, but it's how? Earthly. And how? And what? So if you see something, that is another tree again. Amen? That is earthly. And how? I put this in capital later. And what? Devilish. Is this the wisdom of God? It's the wisdom of who? The wisdom of Satan. Amen? I'm underlining sensual. I'm underlining the lust of the eyes. I'm underlining the lust of the flesh. When you're listening to romantic music, is romantic music playing with sensuality? And if it works with sensual, where is this music coming from? Earthly, and if it's earthly, it is what? Everybody okay? Everybody okay? So, should Christian people listening to romantic music because they're married? Because they have intimate relationship? The man needs some kind of music to spice their relationship? You are bringing devils in your marriage. You will think you are actually spicing your relationship, but you are pulling the devil right there in your husband. Or you're putting the devil in your wife. And before you know it, he won't stop with you. When he goes outside, you open the door for him to begin to go out to other women. And you wonder, why is my husband going out? Because you gave him a worldly woman. Amen? That was playing with a certain music. Remember the rhythm and the beat. And the rhythm of the beat was meant to arouse certain things in the body. And before you know it, you cannot tame it. Because those kind of things are tamed by the worldly women. Not you. You're not trained for those things. You don't have a license for that. They have PhD there. They know what to do with those kind of stuff. Not you. And your husband will be in trouble. Everybody okay? Everybody okay? We good? Let's go to the book of Jude. Hallelujah. It's a very dangerous line when it comes to marriage. Especially the younger couple that got married lately in the message. They don't have no guideline. Amen? And they're opening these things because nobody gave them the gauging of what a Christian marriage should be like. Everybody okay? Brother Branham say adultery, it's a right act done wrong. So you got to know how you're placing that. You place it a certain way, it's adultery. You get married, you go that way, it's no problem. Amen? But you got to know that adultery is different than the correct marriage. Young people have a long trouble. I'm not talking about you folks, those that got married. That's why they get married, they don't stay in church. They after fun. They see the old folks like their marriage is boring. We need to make our marriage really romantic. You're opening the devils. Everybody okay? Everybody okay? Okay. Anyway, I'm going to say it, but I can handle with this in a different depth where I'm talking to married people. Amen? Being married, I'm going with the same line of this question. Amen? Doesn't give you the right to watch pornography. I don't know if you're getting me. It's a trap of the devil. This is why you want to watch pornography for your marriage. Or you want to look at romantic, listen to romantic song for your marriage. You are bringing devils to your husband. I will get to that later. Let's go to the book of Jude. If you dare, you can say amen. I wish the whole church was here. Amen? That's why I want this recorded, if ever it's released. So it goes across all over the world. It's a trap of the devil, especially the people that got married recently, the young people. They want to go like a competition. This one goes in the on the beach with her husband holding them. And then every young people that want to get married want to do the same and show off and put on Facebook and things like that. And before you know, they want to show that they're best romantic. They know romance more than anybody before them. And the romance you're putting up on Facebook, you just copy that from Hollywood. If they were taking a certain poster like this, you just copy them. And before you know it, your husband is struggling. You're the one that brought the devil. You're the one that opened the door to demon. Amen? It's a very difficult line. We have happiness. We have joy. We have marriage. We are like passion. We eat just like everybody. But there is certain things we eat and certain things we don't eat. We drink, but we don't drink anything. We don't drink beer, but we can drink soda. We can drink water. But somebody will try to make you think like because you don't drink beer, you don't have fun. Try beer one time. It's even bitter. Everybody okay? Everybody okay? That's the way it is. But they're trying to show, especially message believer, they're trying to show you that our marriage are boring. We're not boring. We really got the real deal. Who told you it's boring? Who told you it's boring? Do you really know what love is? Oh, because somebody stood on 74 kissing his wife in public. You think that is love? That's fake. I have a question on that, okay? We can handle that. Amen. Jude chapter verse 17. Oh, man. What an anointing. That was quick. Amen. You there? Verse 17. But, beloved, remember ye the words which were spoken before of the apostles of our Lord Jesus Christ. How that they told you there should be mockers in the last time who should walk after their own what? Ungodly lust. Watch verse 19. These mockers that walk after the ungodly lust, these be they who separate themselves. And they are how? Having not the what? When you put a romantic music, what spirit come on you? Because remember, we went through this in music part 1 and 2. Each music that you put on, bring on a spirit. Okay, when you put a romantic music, what spirit comes in you? You need to read me between the line. For young adult, you will be beast. Did you get me? Did you really get me? Did you get me? You will pull on a spirit into your marriage and you will be acting like a bunch of beasts. I hope you're getting what I'm saying. Why? Because you draw a spirit from Hollywood that they inserted a lustful spirit. And when they bring it into your home, this is what you're going to be behaving. Because music will change your life. It will change your dressing. Watch the kind of music people are listening to. Even worldly music, there is category. There is classical music. There is this. The kind of music that they watch goes with their dressing. If the rapper, you will see them putting their pants down and they wear jeans and all kind of stuff. If they are love, they try to act a little bit more sensual. If they're classical, they try to be but devilish. Everybody okay? It is music shaping all of that. If somebody is listening to a rock band, a heavy metal, it goes with their dressing. You will see them on big motorcycle or something like that. It's a lifestyle that goes with the music. The music will direct them to that life. Everybody okay? Everybody okay? Now my question to you and the one that asked the question. If love song is bad, what about the Song of Solomon? In the Bible. What about the Song of Solomon? If love song is bad. So I know how to turn fire on myself. Amen. 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 If you read the Song of Solomon, it's talking about my love, my spouse, my this. And the Bible called that the Song of Solomon. Maybe that's where the person got the question from. Because it's romantic. Everybody okay? Let's go to 2 Timothy chapter 3. My God. You see how this get a hot potato? Music is a very difficult subject. Amen. There are ministers, a minister from Tanzania. He got my number. He's begging. He said, Brother Stephen, please release the tape of music. Because we got a problem in the whole country with music. Release the tape. Because the flood of music that is coming among message believers, it is uncontrolled. It is sweeping all over the world. Message believer. Amen? 2 Timothy chapter 3. If you dare, you can say amen. Verse 16. Where is the Song of Solomon? Where is he written it? Where? Thank you. That's what I wanted. Okay? You ready? 2 Timothy chapter 3, verse 16. If you dare, you can say amen. Amen. Some scripture. What? All scripture. Including the Song of Solomon. Everybody okay? Are we okay? All scripture is given by what? So the Song of Solomon came from God. Everybody okay? Are we okay? Wake up, wake up, wake up. Everybody okay? All scripture is given by inspiration of God. So if the Song of Solomon were inspired by God and they were put in the Bible from God, so it is not really love the way you think. Am I reading a different Bible? Because when God gives a scripture, God has a message. There is a purpose. There is a message that God is trying to bring out through his scripture. Because the scripture is the word of God. God is trying to say something. But why is God trying to say something uses a language of romance? Let me stabilize you a little bit so we can move forward. God is male and female. God got a wife. Everybody okay? The Bible says in the book of Revelation, come let me show you the bride, the Lamb's wife. So God have a wife. And the whole theme of the Bible is wrapped up around marriage. Amen? The Bible in the beginning started with marriage. And the Bible in the book of Revelation is talking about the marriage of the Lamb. That's why Paul in the book of Ephesians 5, when he was talking about husband, love your wife. And toward the end he said, but I'm speaking of who? Christ and we okay now? Let's go back to our scripture. All scripture is given by what? Inspiration of God. And is profitable for what? For what? Reproof for what? correction for instruction in what? That the man of God may be perfect, thoroughly furnished unto all good what? So even the Song of Solomon has a message. And the message in the Song of Solomon are there to correct you. They are there to reprove you. They are there for doctrine. They are there to instruct you in righteousness. If you recall in a hotel, we were preaching on the Song of Solomon. And we were pulling the seals and all kind of stuff were coming up out of it. Because it's not really a love the way you think it. But that was the love between Christ and his bride in shadow. Everybody okay? Let me read Brother Branham before we go to the next scripture. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory, glory. Hallelujah. In the message, The Future Home, in paragraph 297, Brother Branham say, wish we had time. Let me start by 296. He said, Christ, and Christ has gone, and he is preparing a place that has been on its construction for many, many thousand years. You remember that quote. Preparing a place. And if I go and prepare a place, I will come again and receive you, that wherever I am, there you may be also. Notice the Redeemer and they redeemed. Wish we had time now. I got Mark here. Solomon quoting this girl, the bride. Brother Branham said the Shunammite that was in the book of the Song of Solomon was actually the bride in type. Brother Branham continued, he said, oh, we just have to omit it. It's getting too late, see? I shall get it again. When he tries to get her, but she's engaged to a shepherd boy. Some probably thought that was a song he sung. Oh, no. Solomon was the throne inherited of David on earth, but sure that kingdom had to pass away. He was a type of Christ in love with the bride. So the very theme of the Song of Solomon is it is not love the way you think. It is a relationship between Jesus Christ and his bride expressed in love. Everybody okay? Everybody okay? Let me read again, Brother Branham. In the message, Corinthian, book of correction, Brother Branham says, what is the type of Christ? Paragraph 140. Christ from out of his bosom, not a byproduct, not a Methodist, or a Baptist, or a Pentecostal hatchap. No, sir. But out of his own heart, he took a sweetheart that is as pure and loyal as she can be. She is as loyal as a lily. Look back there at Solomon speaking, come, my love, let us walk in the pomegranate. Let us take our fill of love. And when the real believer opened his arm with a pure heart and hold up to Christ, that affection of that lover of Christ, amen, goes into his bosom. It is his wife, just like the husband does to a real wife. So the book of the Song of Solomon are not just romantic, worldly song, but they are a song that was written in tap. Amen? Demonstrating the relationship that Jesus Christ have with his own bride, which naturally we that are married or that will be married must express the same to our wife. Because the Bible say in the book of Ephesians, husband, love your wife as who? Christ has loved the church. So you can look in the Song of Solomon and you can see the example of Christ in shadow, how he loved his wife. Amen? It is a scripture. It is inspired. It is not coming from sensuality. Because anything that is talking about sensual that is promoting the lust of the flesh and the eyes, it is something different. Amen? Amen? Amen. So there is nothing about looking at your wife and say you are beautiful. That love is not the love of you looking at the woman that is half naked. It is two different things. Everybody good? Everybody okay? Let's go to 2 Peter. Amen. Amen. So whoever is struggling with this, or whoever here, because the Holy Spirit allowed this to be brought up as a question, so somewhere, either here or down the road, somebody around the world is struggling with this. Because Message Believer take those song and send to another when they are courting. I know somebody who did that. And later on, their marriage busted. When they were engaged, the man was sending those worldly love song. And they got married, and today they're not married. The woman is left with children. And the man is in another, after other women. Got even another one pregnant. Romantic love. 2 Peter, verse 1. The devil is not somebody you play with. You there? You there? Knowing this first, that no prophecy of the scripture is of any private what? Interpretation. 2 Peter chapter 1, verse 20. Sorry. 2 Peter chapter 1, verse 20. Pages are turning. Knowing this first, that no prophecy of the scripture is of any private interpretation. Why? For the prophecy, in other words, because the prophecy came not in the old time by the will of man. So what Solomon was writing was not by his own will. Because the Old Testament, the very life of those people were an expression of Christ. Remember David was crying, my God, why have thou forsaken me? But he was not really David. It was Jesus Christ down the road. Amen? He said, for the prophecy came not in old time by the will of man, but holy men of God spake as they were moved by the Holy Ghost. So the song of Solomon are not romantic, earthly song. They are inspired. They are from God. It is a book of love that is expressing the love between Christ and the church. And according to the book of Ephesians, a husband must love the wife just like Christ loved the church. Amen? That is an expression of agape love, which is the pure love, which is the love of God. But other than that, every other song that have a theme that is not center of God, but the theme is stressing the lust of the flesh, it's stressing the lust of the eyes, and it's stressing the pride of life. Something that when you listen, it begins to raise your senses. You need to stay away because you're bringing devils to yourself and you're bringing devils to the one that is listening with you. And before you know it, you are battling with a lust demon. Because the music can make a child rebellious, or music can tame you and can give you a good atmosphere. But usually, the reason why we go through this kind of stuff, we want to set up the atmosphere for something in our marriage. Yeah, you are setting up the atmosphere with something that is wrong. Actually, you are bringing devil to churn that atmosphere for you. And before you know it, one day you're going to open the telephone and you will see your husband telephone filled with women naked. And you will wake up. And it's too late. Because you're the one that were feeding that demon. Young folks, don't get into that line. There is a way you can live godly without this kind of stuff. Everybody okay? Everybody okay? Second question about music. Remember Philippians 4:8, right? Whatever is good, whatever is acceptable, whatever that is the standard. Amen? Second question about music. All right. God bless you, Brother Stephen. I hope you are well. I have a question concerning music. I like that introduction. I remember in that YouTube video you shared a couple months ago where a preacher mentioned how holy in church music differ from human celebration music. Would you say that party, like a birthday event or wedding, need to follow the same guideline as holy in church music, or do you agree that it is different? Did you hear the question? Amen? In other words, what do we do in our parties? Do we play music in our party? Amen? What do we do? Can we dance in our party? What do we do? Amen? Glory, glory, hallelujah. Ah, let's go to the book of Luke. Chapter 15. You there? Please wake up. Or maybe somebody's trembling. Amen. Luke chapter 15, verse 23. If you're there, you can say amen. You know the story, right? Let me start from verse 21. So it makes sense. You there? And the son say unto him, Father, I have sinned against the heaven, and in thy sight, and I am no more worthy to be called thy son. You know the story, right? It is the story of who? The prodigal son. But the father said to his servant, bring forth the best robe and put it on him, and put a ring on his hand, and shoes on his feet, and bring hither the fatted calf. We need to have some steak. Amen? And kill it. Steak come from calf. Ox. Beef. Okay. And kill it. And let us eat and be how? For this my son was dead and is how? Alive again. He was lost and is now? That's the theme of your amazing grace. And they begin to be merry. Now his eldest son was in the field, and as he came and drew nigh to the house, he heard what? And what? Can you read with me? He heard what? I need to turn those microphones. Brother Keller, those microphones are on. Right? The ones that are on the light. So they can pick up those amen. Amen? Amen? They begin to hear what? Music and what? So somebody heard somebody playing music and people are dancing. We good? Can I continue? Verse 26. And he called one of the servants and asked, were these things what? What is going on with this party? And not only the party, I'm hearing dancing and I'm hearing music. Why do we have this? What is the purpose of this? What is the message behind this? What is the message behind the party? What is the message behind the music? What is the message behind the dancing? They're not just dancing. They're dancing because of something. Everybody okay? Everybody okay? Amen. He says, and he says unto him, thy brother is come, and thy father has killed the fatted calf, because he has received him how? And what? So, who's giving this parable? Who's telling the story? Don't be afraid. It is not you. Just repeat what the Bible says. Who's giving the story? Jesus is giving the story about a son that was lost into the world. And when God rescued the son, when the son came, he turned into an atmosphere of joy. And that joy could not go just joy with eating. They couple joy with some music and some water. In other words, they celebrate the return of the son. In music and in dancing. Psalm 149. I could not leave this one. So this one, the Lord touched this person that, Brother Stephen, whatever you left need to be put together. So my children will be balanced before people become starchy. They get to church, but in their heart. Everybody okay? Everybody okay? Okay. Psalm 149 verse 1. 149. Music is very treacherous and very dangerous. No wonder it took 6 hours. And now we're adding more than 6 hours. Amen? So if you deal with it in 30 minutes, you will have a bunch of questions that are pulling up and people are still confused. Praise ye the Lord. Verse 1. Sing unto the Lord the what? And his praise in the congregation of the? Okay. Let Israel rejoice in him that made him. Let the children of Zion be joyful in their king. You ready? You ready? Verse 3. Let them praise his what? In the what? It's easy to praise his name in word. Praise the Lord. I love you, Jesus. But this praise, it is a praise in dance. So this dance is not really just dance. Get me? I have to say this so we don't see foolishness when you get married. Amen. I want you to be happy on your marriage day, but without foolishness. Okay? If not, we'll be religious in the marriage day, and that's not what I'm saying. Amen? This is not just dancing. It is dancing in praising the name of the Lord. Amen? In other words, there is a cause for your dance. There is something that happened. That is bringing the dancing. You're not just dancing to be the big shot in the marriage. Everybody okay? Everybody okay? You're not just dancing because this is what everybody's doing. You are dancing in revelation. David never came out from his home and just begin to dance. No, there was a purpose. They were bringing the Ark of the Covenant. When they're bringing the Ark of the Covenant, something struck David. So the dancing of David is not just dancing empty. It is dancing because of the Ark is coming. Everybody okay? Everybody okay? Let's go to Psalm 150. Mm-mm-mm. If you there, you can say amen. Verse 4. You there? Praise him with the water. Everybody can do this. Dun, 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 dun. Oh, that's holy. Everybody okay? Praise him with the timbrels and water. So the dance is a praise. Amen? Amen? It is another way of praising God. Everybody okay? Everybody okay? Somebody, the anointing can come and they begin to lift up the hand. Leave them alone. They are lifting up their hand in praising to the Lord. Somebody, the anointing can strike them and then they turn out dancing. They're not dancing for you. Amen. They didn't just come in church and start dancing. Amen. You don't know what God did in their life. Amen. You don't know that son that was lost. And because of that, they are celebrating. Everybody okay? Amen. The direction of their dance. The purpose of their dance. The one to whom they are dancing is not a boyfriend. Is not to show the people how big you are. Because those kind of dance will kill the prophet. They have not called it yet. I'm going to say again. Those kind of dance kills the prophet. They have not called it yet. I'm going to say the third time. If you don't catch it, then I'll drop it. Those kind of dance of show kills the prophet. Now I got to drop it. The daughter of Herodias. On the birthday party, she danced so good and pleased the people, not God. He pleased the king and the guest, and he caused the death of a prophet. So your kind of dancing in reception place, you can kill the influence of the message. Is everybody in this place? I hope nobody's out somewhere. Tell them to come inside. Everybody okay? Everybody okay? Everybody okay? Herodias danced. The daughter of Herodias danced so much, so good, until the people say everybody in the whole birthday party was so pleased. And the father say, ask me even to the half of the kingdom. What kind of dance was she dancing? Was it holy? Amen. And because of that dance, because of pleasing everybody, he opened the door that the Jezebel spirit that was on Herodias took its door to go cut the head of John the Baptist. When you dancing on the reception, what is the purpose of your dancing? Why are you jumping? Why? There's nothing wrong about jumping. But we want to know, why are you jumping? Everybody okay? Amen? They hit the music. I wish all these young boys and young people were here. Amen? They just put the music and everybody's there. Boom, boom, boom. They start jumping. Why are you jumping? What did God did for you? Amen? Are you jumping because, oh, my sister finally got married. We want to praise the Lord. Let's rejoice all together. That's a different way. Or are you dancing because, this is the time, man. Let's go ahead and hit it. Amen. That's when you're going to find the spirit get on you and the sister that was tall like this become shorter like this. You will see her going all the way, breaking it down. So you're breaking it down in glory to God. Why are you dancing? Amen? 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 When Israel crossed the Red Sea, amen, and the Egyptians were coming, and God destroyed the army, then the anointing struck Miriam. Not just like that. There was a purpose. There was a cause. And Miriam picked up the tambourine and here she goes dancing. Brother Branham said that was a Pentecostal. Why? Why are you dancing, Miriam? Why are you so happy? I am dancing because of a victory. I am dancing because I was in a hospital. Now I'm back safe home. That's the reason why I'm dancing. Because we must praise him also in dance. You are dangerous. Amen. 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 Let me see if I can find that scripture. Lord, please help me. Amen. Amen. That scripture should be in the book of the Judges, I believe. Hopefully, I can find it. Oh, glory, glory. Judges chapter 11. I see the horrible stuff in message wedding. They just get, hey, 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 what is her? Her is now breaking down. Go ahead and dance. And this first one goes and dance and come out. Then they say, next one and the next one. When are you getting? What are you doing? It's a competition. Then the next one will try to dance to outshine the first one. What did God do to you? Amen. Turn on the cell phone. Boom. Turn on the cell phone light. What is the cell phone light doing? Praising God. Amen. Turn the light there. What are you doing with a light there as a Christian? Smoking? What are you doing? Praising the Lord with a light there? For what? What does it mean? Amen. What are you dancing? We don't have a problem. Amen. All I'm saying, I'm bringing everything by the word. So you want to dance here, we don't have any problem. But just know, when you come in here dancing, know that you must have a purpose. If not, we will catch you. We want to know the testimony, sister. We saw you breaking it down. What did God do to you? Amen. What did God do to you? Amen. If Sister Angie was here singing, you saw her getting under the spirit because God did something for the baby. We understand that. There is a reason why she's doing that. She didn't come to say, I'm going to show off. No. I am singing because I was in the hospital. That baby, they say she had COVID and pneumonia. So if they heal her from COVID and pneumonia, that was talking about death right there. That's why we are praising him. If we preach the anointing is so good and everybody's dancing, there's nothing wrong. Because your dance is a result of the sermon. It is the sermon that got that anointing until you see something and everything broke loose. And then you find yourself going around and this one is going around. That's a different dancing. Amen. You don't care who's there. But if you say, well, there are boys there, I want to get married. Now you step on a pod and you start dancing so that the boys can see you. That's the problem. Don't worry, we smell that quickly. Where I am, it's like. I said, don't worry, young lady, I already got you. It's amazing. I've seen things crazy in the message churches. Somebody want to show shoes, they will wake up, they wait. When everybody's sitting, that's when they stand up to go to the bathroom. And you're just sitting there like a deacon in the old church. You just look like this, you shake your head. You say, you think you're fooling somebody. You want to show your boots. Amen. I've seen a lot of stuff. The bride have a discernment. You don't fool nobody in this church. You're fooling yourself. You'll find after 5 months, everybody was just watching you. You say, oh, we already know. Really? Yes. You were struggling. Yes, of course. It's not new news. I'm just waiting for you. I know you were struggling. Don't even worry about it. Let's move forward. Judges chapter 11, verse 34. If you dare, you can say amen. Amen. Jephthah, you know the story of Jephthah now. He made a vow to the Lord. And he went and the Lord gave him the victory. Remember, David also was coming from the victory. And the women were coming. Amen. With dancing and what? Music. Because what? Not just because David is coming, they're coming with victory. No, because David was bringing the victory. That's what caused a celebration. Amen? Now, Jephthah is coming from a victory. Look what he's causing. Amen? Verse 34. And Jephthah came to Mizpah unto his house. And behold, his daughter came out to meet him with what? Timbrels and with what? Everybody okay? So there is an event that brings this kind of stuff. Amen? There is a victory that was won. When the victory is won, automatically it's bringing something. Amen? They're not just dancing like crazy. Amen? They are dancing in thanksgiving. Amen? The purpose of your dance. Remember, the book of Psalms say, praise him, his name, in dancing. So your dancing is actually to praise his name. Not to praise somebody. Not to praise a boyfriend. Not to praise the young people. If you're doing that, you're already out. That's why you get out of line. Because the motive is already wrong. Amen? Okay, let me read Brother Branham a little bit. Brother Branham says this. Oh my, I hope this won't take too long. In the message by faith, Moses, he says, the other day, coming down the road, I turned on my radio, and there was a song, and I kept listening. And I had to take nearly the song through before I could tell whether it was absolutely a religious song. Amen? Or the devil is trying to bring down the things of God to the level of the world. You can do that. God be merciful. I don't care how many albums Elvis Presley writes and all the good religious songs. These are religion songs that are written or sung by a secular artist. It's a dangerous ground. When you saw somebody who was singing for the world begin to sing the Christian song, don't get it. Even if they tell you, no, he already repented. He changed his life. He's a Christian. Slow down. Brother Branham said we need to see his life first. If his life changed, then we can see where he's going. Who told you that he was, he's a true Christian? Were you there when he was in the altar? Everybody okay? Brother Branham say he's still possessed of the devil. He's singing religious song, but Brother Branham is saying the man still have the devil. He sent more children to hell. And all the move I know of in all the world in this day, Patbone and the rest of them, he belonged to the Church of Christ. And Elvis Presley, a Pentecostal. They are Judas Iscariot. In the form of those men. The devil is trying to bring the high things of God, music, so that they can mix them down here. The people won't look up above this. They just look here and say, well, it's all the same. It is not the same. Get out of the land. Everybody okay? Second one. I don't want church. I don't want the church to fall in the step that you will find over there in England. Long hair, painted face, and pervert. We don't want that. No matter how religious it sounds and how much Elvis Presley can sing a religious song, he's still a devil. I am no judge, but by their fruit, you know them. He is a Pentecostal, but that don't make a bit of difference. Your fruit bear record of what you are. Everybody okay? Everybody okay? Now let's get to this dancing and our celebration. Brother Branham says, now I'm speaking directly in a message demonology to Christian so that you could see the pro and cons and con, the negative and the positive. Where there is anybody ask you, then you can give them an answer. Now, of everything that God has, the devil has a counterfeit. You go and whatever you want to do, you find like these old dances. That is of the devil, but God has a holy dance for the people. Everybody okay? Amen. Praise God. It's on the board. I was one of the greatest critics on that you ever seen. Till God told me just what to do. I found out that Miriam danced in the spirit. David danced when he had victory. Oh my, many times. All of it through was victory. He was dancing, holy dancing. Now, message believer, today are producing song where they're dancing with nothing but with the hips. Go on YouTube. I can show you. Horrible. Message believer, I'm not talking about Pentecostal. I'm not even talking about the people in the world. I'm talking about message believer. They are praising the Lord and they're dancing so sexy. And before you know it, almost every celebration of the message believer in those countries, you go see the children are dancing like that because the one who produced their song is a message believer. Everybody okay? In the message at that word, Brother Branham says this, dancing. Could there be a time for a little bit of testimony right here? When I first come among the Pentecostal people and seen them dancing, them dance on the floor, now that was just too much for my self-styled Baptist way, you know. So I said, looky here, now dancing belong out. Other type of people. I say not religious people. I hear the music go to playing, the people go to crying and to shouting. After a while, somebody start dancing. I say, I don't want to be critical, but as sure I'm afraid to say something against God that would not be right. I never did criticize anything like that. And I say, well, but you know, I can't get that. I said, I wish I could see that in the Bible. We're talking about dancing. And one night I was having teaching on a chart, the second coming of Christ, and from Louisville, Kentucky, come a group of people over there, and there was some young ladies, and they had one of them was a piano player, and the other one had cymbals and a washboard. And my, they was making as much music out of that as a brass band almost. You okay? Let's listen to Brother Branham. So I was teaching on the second coming. So then a few days before that, I had been up to Salem, Indiana, where there was some Pentecostal people just getting acquainted with them. And they were dancing and going on. And I got to running a reference. I found out that dancing, the first time I noticed it, Miriam began to dance. I thought, well, that must be from God. And the devil just pardoned it off of it. You see, Brother Branham say, well, then the next, I noticed that David danced when they saw the ark coming down the road. Miriam, there is a purpose. God killed the Egyptian. David, there is a purpose. The ark is coming. The prodigal son, there is a purpose. My son that was lost is coming. Jephthah, there was a purpose. He won a battle. It's coming. David, there was a purpose. Always a purpose. Everybody okay? And notice that David danced when he saw the ark coming down the road. See, and I thought, my, that's wonderful. And I noticed the king has made a rash vow one time. That's Jephthah. And he vowed that he sacrificed the first thing that come from his house. And here come his daughter. That was Jephthah. And the daughter rejoicing, dancing. I read that to you. And notice how dancing was victory. I'm reading Brother Branham. We cannot take dancing out of the scripture. Dancing is of the scripture. If you want to praise the Lord, worship the Lord, and you tell the people, don't dance, you off on one lamb. We must keep the balance and bring everything down to the word. Because now it becomes the preference of the pastor. But you cannot be as holy, more holy than the scripture. Amen. We want you to dance, but Brother Branham said, God got holy dances. If your dancing is sexy, it is stumbling people, you only dance in one part of your body, not any body part. So you need to slow down and get that body part saved. I am sorry, this is just your pastor. Amen. 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 Because we don't want something that is obscene, something that is filthy. Because the preview of the bride, amen, amen, I have the coat, amen. Brother Branham say the bride that was coming on the end time got off the step by watching the Pentecostal church. When message believer, their eyes, all their music is only on Pentecostal music, it will get you off the line. Everybody okay? Everybody okay? Because the Pentecostal is a lukewarm place. You need a strong filter to take something and to push the other one. You might find 10, you might pull 3 out, and 7 need to go back. Everybody okay? Everybody okay? Brother Branham said, I noticed how dancing was victory. And I thought, well, maybe I just had not got victory enough. Maybe that's what that is what it is. Maybe just a little bit of self has to die out yet. This is Brother Branham. Was not long after that. I was sitting there and I just got through teaching on the second coming of Christ. And oh, the Spirit of God just taking our time moving. And it was on a New Year's night. So I've been teaching about 2 hours. They was all sitting around, a group of people in my tabernacle. So they was going to have a special. I believe we got some folks from Louisville back there. Some of them wrote a little note and put on there. So they give it to Brother John Porter. And had one to play a special. Well, I say, come ahead. Brother Branham called them. And so these 3 or 4 ladies got up and come up. And one got on the piano. And she started playing. There is going to be a meeting in the air. Everybody okay? You understand the song, right? You know the song, right? You see the theme of the song. Okay? And you know who they are singing to. Okay? So you gotta check all those lines. This is like an airplane that have to take off. If you play, you're going to kill people and kill yourself. So make sure whenever you come in the morning, you got to check everything. Check the fuel. Check, 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 check. Because you're taking people off. Everybody okay? Brother Branham say, and they begin to play, there is going to be a meeting in the air, in the street, in the meeting in the air. And when she start, just raise up. Start a dissemble on this voice call, then hitting the tin can down there like that. My, it got pretty good, you know. Brother Branham. I noticed there. Then after a while, there was a little girl jump out on the floor there and start dancing up and down, jumping around. I thought, oh, right in my own church. Here it is. Now, I'm ruined for this. So I kept watching her. And you know, I kept hearing here at this, here real, that lady playing on the piano, till I believe if there be 3 or 4 deck of keys, she could have played them. And she was playing this God's own song, will be the leading one on at a meeting in the air. And she no more than get half out of that till she start again. I thought, And she got real white in the face. Do you see who's picking up the music?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Do you see who's picking up the music? Yes, amen? She got real white in the face. And she her eyes was how? So this have nothing anymore to do with humanistic. Amen? She was not jumping over there to show off to the people. She forget about the people. My son, who came out from a car wreck, didn't die. That's what is taking me. Amen? Praise God. He says, Brother Branham say, oh my God, where was I? Yes, and her eyes closed and playing like that. I thought, say, I got to feeling pretty good. Got to patting my foot with that girl. Brother Branham found himself, he began to pat his foot. Amen? You know, I thought, well, maybe that is just my Methodist foot. Anyhow. Amen? So I started patting a little bit, you know. So, you know, it was not very long till I was out there with that girl doing what? Who took Brother Branham there? I'm asking you a question. Brother Branham didn't want to dance. Who took him there? Who took him there? When you're going to dance in the party, who took you there? Who told you to jump on the party? The DJ? The DJ said, come on, girls, come on. Everybody okay? Brother Branham said, he found himself dancing. I got the water. Everybody okay? Well, that is what it takes. Isn't it? The victory. Just get away from water. Follow me carefully. And just let the water have water. The right of way. Say, well, he said decently and orderly. It shall be decently in order. Just let it go, the water. In other words, if it's the Holy Spirit that touches you to dance, don't worry about decently and orderly. The Holy Spirit knows how to make you move until you will be in order. Everybody okay? So do we need music for celebration? Yes. We want to celebrate God. A young sister got married. No problem. But whoever is getting married, make sure that DJ is saved. Make sure the DJ is saved. Make sure the DJ follow to part 1 and part 2 and part 3. Everybody okay? If not, the DJ will stumble you. Because music are selective. They can play a certain music and certain people won't move. But if you turn around, you play a certain one, you will see even the one that was drinking drop the stuff and he goes right quickly. Because that music just catch him like, now we gotta go. Everybody okay? It depends on the DJ. The whole nightclub in downtown Charlotte is rocked by the DJ. The DJ knows what music to rock and the whole nightclub is on fire. Amen. 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 So call that DJ and tell him, did you listen to part 1? Did he listen to part 2? Did you listen to part three? Because we don't want a scandal. We want to worship God. We want to praise God. We want to celebrate. We want to be happy. We want to dance in honor to the Lord for what the Lord has done, for the year he has added to our sister, or for the marriage he has given to our brother, for the marriage he has given to our sister. We want to be happy. Amen. In gratitude, in thanksgiving unto the Lord, not unto the people. Not dance to please mommy. Not dance to please daddy. You're going to dance like the daughter of Herodias. And you're going to kill the influence of the message. Everybody okay? So when you have marriage, remember. Amen? Let it dance. And the people look, they say, well, we didn't know. These people have fun. They have life. And they're dancing. They're happy. They're joyful. All of them, we can see them. Look at the way they support one another. Until somebody want to be part of you. Until somebody's longing like, what kind of church is this? Everybody's happy. That's what we want. Amen? And when we come out there, you won't hear anybody saying that, did you see so and so how he danced? You will see everybody like, man, that was so good. We had a good time. And nobody even remember what dance you were dancing. All we know that we were just rejoicing because Sister Rebecca Porter got married. That's all. That's all. Do you remember anything? All you remember was a wonderful May wedding. That's all we remember. Amen? Why? Because music is part of it. It's part of a worship. It's part of a praise. You can worship with instrument. You can worship with song. You can worship with this. You can worship with this. You can worship with dancing. You remove it, you are killing something. Amen? And if somebody look at you dancing in the spirit and play around with it, it's a trouble. Because it's not you dancing. It is the Holy Spirit doing the dancing in you. Then you be careful like the wife of David. Amen. Amen. Because it's not you. It is the Spirit of God that is doing it. So if the Holy Spirit come and somebody's dancing, leave him alone. You don't know what God did for them. Everybody okay? Everybody okay? Did I answer your question? That was music part three. Amen. Oh my God. Let's see if we can get the question that blend with this. That was question two, right? There is another question. This is very important. Okay, let me go through this and go to that one. Can someone have question number three? When we finish the CD, the remaining of the question will cut them off. We will kind of split that and keep music and the other one separate. Because if I release, I don't want them to hear the thunders. Can someone, or not having it yet, for example, couple who are not in the message, but you know they have true love for each other by how they treat one another. Can I read it again? Yes. Can someone have unconditional love for their spouse without the Holy Spirit? Or not having it yet? Or, for example, couple who are not in the message, but you know that they have true love for each other by how they treat one another. Hot potato, buddy. Amen. I know the background behind this. The background is we usually say, before you get married, get the Holy Ghost. Right? So now if somebody don't have the Holy Ghost and they got married, can they have true love, unconditional love? I know your mind is running. Opening this, flipping, open the cabinet, close, bang here, boom, boom. Trying to find an example, put it here. Yeah, what about? Yeah. I remember. Oh, no, my father was married for so long. They didn't divorce, so have true love. All of that is coming up. Nobody want to say something? Brother Kelly has the microphone. You want to say something? Go ahead, Brother Mike. Amen. Amen.